What is up, Fitches, and welcome back to my channel. Guys, if you saw my last video, you already know that I'm coming off of my third hectic weekend in a row. And by hectic, I mean not entirely sticking to my macros over the weekend. And when you don't hit your macros for like 3 weekends in a row, it can start to be questionable. Like, am I falling into this vicious cycle of eating good during the week and then basically ruining all my efforts on the weekend? And I don't really think that's the case. Every time I go to my parents' house, there is so much food. And not to mention, like, holidays or family parties in general are always like my biggest struggle. Like, I don't know what happens, but it's just like there's so much good food to the point where it's like even if you ate a little bit of everything, you'd be overeating. And then that's basically what I do. So it's a thing. It's a problem. Everyone has things they gotta work on. You know, I'm not going to stay stuck in the fact that I screwed up 3 weekends in a row. When, not gonna lie, but I actually went like 3-4 months in a row of like not really screwing up at all. But it's like the minute you do poorly, it's like that's all you can think about. I know it's a common thing for some of us to overeat on the weekend, and then that guilt sets in. There's all those emotions that linger for like days after you overeat, you know, especially depending on how much you did overeat. Maybe it was a lot or a little, but I totally get you, and I get those feelings, and you know, I've had those feelings. And honestly, what I do keep telling myself is you're gonna dig yourself out of this. Like, that's what you gotta do. You gotta dig yourself out, and we're gonna do this. I tell myself that, like, you got this. You know what to do. You know how to hit your macros. You know how to hit your macros on a weekend. You know how to say no to treats and things that will, you know, throw you off track. You know how to do that. And I just remind myself that. I pretty much just hate the feeling of being lethargic, bloated, and feeling like I overate. But unfortunately, that's life and it does happen. And you got to move on from those situations. And you know that those situations are not defining at all, because I know who I am and I know the type of self-control and discipline that I do have. And just because I do something every so often, you know, I tell myself that I'm only human. You know what I mean? I'm not always going to be perfect. I'm going to strive to be, because you know what they say. You shoot for the moon. If you miss, at least you'll land among the stars. So you know what I mean? You want to strive to do as good as you can do, but you're going to have your screw ups. So the best way to jump right back out of that is to take an Orangetheory fitness class. And that's what we're about to do. I'm actually about to hit up Orangetheory Fitness Allentown with Coach Nadine, and I've never taken her class before. I specifically scheduled myself into Nadine's class like 3 weeks in advance. 3 weeks. I was like, this is happening. I'm gonna hit her up on the IG. I slid into that DM. She was really cool about it. Moving on to some really good news, guys. I got my tooth fixed. On the note, can you see it? My dentist killed the game. He slayed it. My tooth, it's unreal. So yeah, if you guys missed that, I chipped my tooth in Orangetheory Fitness class and now it's fixed and I'm so happy about it. Here we go, guys. Without further ado, let's head over to the studio. Here we are, rolling on up, rolling up. Here we go. They ain't ready for it. They ain't ready for the fitty. Sometimes I feel as though my presence can be somewhat alarming to some people that are not prepared for it, but it's who I am, right? Sorry, guys. Guys, this is the Orangetheory beauty bar that I always talk about in my story. I wish the ones near me had this. Getting ready for work. I need a picture there one day.
Alrighty, so 3 G's. 3 groups, floors open, we move a little quicker. You take that water, you take that break when I tell you to, got it? I will move on with or without you here. On the treadmill today, you have a bunch of all outs. For your push paces today, focus, conserve that energy. You're going to need it for your all out. On the floor, we got some fun exercises. I'm super excited to show you that today. If you're starting on the rower, we have an exercise paired with our rowing block today. So we're gonna enter through that way. 5 or less classes, hands up. Damn, all pros are me. All right, awesome. You guys remember the zones, 3, 4, 5. 3, orange, red, let's walk and talk. 12 minutes to that orange and red zone.
I'm out here looking for you, where you at? Running late at night to get you back. Running late at night to get you back. I was just trying to do me, trying to succeed with this music. I know I spend too much time in the studio. I know you don't support that shit, but I need you in my life, that's why I'm looking for you. I'm looking for you. I'm looking for you right now. I'm looking for you right now.
exercise. Remember, it's power day, so I want explosive movements here. Grab a seat on the deck. Dumbbells come out by your side. Keep your knees together here. Remember, heel those shoulders back. Chest is nice and prominent here. I am curling up. From this position, I'm squeezing the crap out of my biceps. Standing up, keeping my core super tight. I'm taking a seat back down, releasing and resetting here. Okay, guys? Then we're going into a bench sit up to jump squat. Once again, find that seat first. Roll it back, engage the core. Come up, explosive jump. Option, you can just hit that sit up. Stand up here, try to be cute with it. Move up, just squat that way.
That's why I'm looking for you. I'm looking for you right now. I'm looking for you right now. I'm looking for you right now.
Taken a 3G in so long.
Really?
But I really haven't. I used to take them all the time at 5 a.m. and then I used to like not like them, but now I love them again. Like it's been a minute.
Yeah.
It's been a minute,
yeah.
But this playlist was fire. This is Coach Nadine.
Hi!
So we're at Orangetheory Fitness Allentown for a little change of pace. I know I'm hopping around, but today we're at Allentown. Coach Nadine, tell us a little bit about yourself. You are an Orangetheory Fitness coach.
Yes.
How long have you been doing it?
Literally 4 months.
4 months?
I've only been open for like maybe 5 months. This is my first time being a coach ever. I love it, yeah.
Well, you're actually really good at like your confidence. You're there.
Hey,
some people are like a little bit nervous. Like, but you're
owning it. I'm this tall.
Yeah, she's, yo, look at her. She's a shawty. She's a certified shawty.
Yeah, you're powerful. You can't let people walk all over you, literally, and
yeah.
They will. I would like love that you were in my class.
I know. I had
to call you out in class. I had to.
No, that was amazing.
I had to.
Let's go, Fitty Freckles.
I came from Philly.
Okay.
Moved back to Allentown, getting everything situated here. Saw that Orangetheory is coming here. I was like, what? Allentown? Like, no.
Yeah. Right. Well, you killed it today. Thanks for having me. I'm becoming a bad one. Guys, this is like my mom's favorite coach.
Oh my God.
So we're gonna have to do a mother-daughter workout. Yeah. She kept telling me to come to your class. She's like, Emily, you're gonna love her music.
Orangetheory,
we out. All right, bitches, I just got done with my Orangetheory workout, and let me tell you guys, that was everything. I burned just under 700 calories. I think I got over 40 splat points. My chart is popping. Coach Nay had the fire beat. She had Migos, Cardi B, Drake. Guys, if you know me, you know that I love rap, okay? And Drake and Cardi B and Migos. And I love taking Orangetheory class on a Monday. There's nothing that can kick off your week better than starting it off with an Orangetheory class. Like, am I right or am I right? I'm definitely feeling motivated and ready to move forward with the week, just hit my macros, not really focus on the mistakes I made in the past 3 weeks, and try to remind myself of all the good times that I had. It's so easy to get caught up in our mistakes. It really truly is. Like, you're not perfect. You're gonna go out with your friends and drink and eat too much pizza, which I definitely did the other day. If you were with me, you know who you are. It was crazy. It's interesting. But this is life, it's a journey, and there's always going to be the ups and the downs. And like I said in my last video, you're gonna have different periods of time where you are way more self-disciplined than others, and it's going to come and go, and you just gotta really try to hang on to it, and you can't let yourself spiral out of control. And you also need to realize when you're working yourself up, and maybe when you really didn't even overeat that much. And I just want you to know that it's totally normal to mess up, because I mess up, I know you mess up, we all mess up. Nobody's perfect. That is just how life is, and it's a journey, and you keep going, and you ride the ups and you ride the downs. So anyways, guys, that concludes today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up because it really supports my channel. Don't forget to subscribe so you never miss another Fitty Freckles video again. Follow me on Instagram, and I will see you in my next video.